So good afternoon, everybody. I represent Insulation Energy. We are a module manufacturers, and my name is Vineet Tyagi, and I head sales and marketing team at Insulation. So we market our modules in the brand name of INA. INA basically is a Sanskrit word, and it has a meaning sun rays. So that is the significance of INA. We are based out of Jaipur, with a 60 megawatt of annual module manufacturing capacity. We are into business for the last two decades, and our sister concern is Fluidcon Engineers, who are into very diverse fields like steel, industrial pipes, real estates, health and fitness centers, and then we have Insulation Energy. We are also as an independent solar power producer with 2 megawatt of plant at Ujjain and another 1 megawatt at Bikaner. So coming back to Insulation Energy, it is one of the most advanced fully automatic 60 megawatt of SPV module manufacturing facility. We started in April 2017, and I am happy to share that we are going to add another line soon to it, and it will be a 100 megawatt capacity soon. It is a least manual intervention and continuous automatic process with a spread out of more than 65,000 square feet of area with automatic stingers, both pre and post, automatic framing machines, and AAA class sun simulator. Just like to take you through the entire process. The first step is the glass loading, then followed up with EVA cutters, stringing, bussing sections. Then we have a pre-yield tester, followed by lamination, post-yield testers, then framing, and finally the sun simulator with the sorting. Just like to highlight a pre-lamination yield tester. In the morning session, we were talking about the quality. Right, so this is a very important step in that, because once the lamination is done, nothing can be done. So to sort out any kind of defects during the pre-lamination states, you can actually see through the pre-lamination test itself. This is the OK module, and in the next slide you can see the dark spots. So any kind of current losses, any kind of misconnections, any kind of any other deformities, it can be checked and cured itself before the lamination starts. These are the actual photographs of our production flow. So coming back to the topics, since the morning we have been discussing about price coming down, safeguard duties, anti-dumping duties. So just to give a background on that, we have already crossed more than 15 gigawatt of solar cumulative installations, with more than 7 gigawatt being added this year. And rooftop installations, a good news, we have crossed 1 gigawatt of mark. And now renewables almost comprises 18% of the total installed capacity of India, with solar accounting for 4.5%. Next year, it is forecasted to cross 8 gigawatt, in fact, this year, and tariff have come down to 2.5 kilowatts per hour. Now, the key challenges which are facing the Indian market. So I think the first and the foremost and the latest one is the safeguard duty. The Directorate General has already recommended 70% safeguard duty against China and Malaysia for the initial 200 days, and it will be further followed by the Committee on Finance Secretaries, Commerce Revenues and Industrial Policies and External Affairs before it is being rolled out as a rule. The next is, already we are facing problems the last 2-3 months. The Central Board of Excise and Custom has already imposed 7.5% duty on imported modules, and with the cess, it is coming down to around 7.8 or maybe around 8%. We've already been talking about anti-dumping duty for the last 4-5 years. It is again in the pipeline again. And the latest, we have seen the prices spikes compared to last year, quarter, half yearly one. The prices have gone up by 14%. Then there have been PPN renegotiation in certain states, and issues surrounding the incomplete infrastructures. And there are many projects which are complete but unable to get connected to the grid. And finally, there is a confusion regarding the goods and service tax. The different components are taxed at different rates, and there is ambiguity regarding that. And lastly, but not the least, the imposition of BIS norms. Of late, government has made it mandatory the BIS norms to be effective from 1st of April this year. So The companies who have already having IEC certificates and all, they have to get it done again through the BIS norms. Though, even though we don't have the sufficient facilities to test these kind of things, but still it has been made mandatory from April. Thank you.